Good afternoon. Will you please give me a bit of a background to yourself?
All right. Thank you very much. My name is Richmond Juvenalishi. I'm from Ghana. I was born in Elibo, a little village in the western region of Ghana. I had my basic education in Elibo, where I attended Roman Catholic primary and junior high school. From there, I proceeded to St. John's School, secondary, to read general arts. From there, I moved to Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, Kumasi, to go and read Bachelor of Science in Land Economy. And from there, I find myself in the University of Cambridge.
Thank you. Will you please tell me why you specifically chose Cambridge University to pursue further study?
Wow, that's really a very big question. I will attempt to answer it anyway. I think my reason for choosing Cambridge ahead of all other universities is quite diverse. I should say that in terms of academic pedigree, Cambridge actually has chalked a lot of successes. Currently, it is ranked fifth in the world according to the Times classification, but in the UK, Cambridge is currently number one. And consistently for the past 3 years, Cambridge has been ranked the number one university in the UK. So in terms of academic pedigree, research capabilities, quality of graduates, graduate employability, general exposure, you can actually vouch for Cambridge graduates. Aside that, I would also want to touch on the state-of-the-art teaching and learning facilities in the University of Cambridge. You get exposed to so many things, new technologies, teaching and learning aid that is actually helping people to actually understand difficult things to really grapple with. I think we have professors, we have tutors who are actually leading experts in their field. That's one remarkable thing about Cambridge. We don't just have lecturers or tutors. We have people who are leading experts in their field, who have diverse and they have a lot of publications. So they are not teaching you things that they are borrowing from somewhere. Mainly they are teaching you things they are very confident of, things they themselves have experimented, things they themselves have produced. So it's like you are in the hub where knowledge is produced and knowledge is directly imparted to you. So you don't just live half-baked, but you live thoroughly baked as a graduate. Aside that, I think that Cambridge has a very long tradition which everyone wants to be associated with. So, and I also look at the prospects. You know, Cambridge has a diverse pool of alumni. The network of alumni is quite wide, ranging across continents from Africa to Asia. You definitely find a Cambridge alumni somewhere, and that network actually creates some sort of value for you. Probably in the future when you are looking for a job, you never know when you chance on another Cantabrian. So I think these and many other things actually motivated me to choose Cambridge ahead of other universities.
Thank you. That's a very comprehensive answer. Finally, Richmond, will you tell me how you found living in the city itself? How are you settling here at the University of Cambridge?
All right. I think for some of us coming from the tropics in Africa, where you have a daily average temperature around 28 degrees Celsius, you really find it struggling settling in, judging from the fact that the weather here is a little different. Yeah, and sometimes it can really get very cold, so you don't step out without a jacket. So I find the weather a little challenging, but I think little by little we are really adapting. You know, the system has to really adjust to the weather. I think in terms of the social life on campus, I think it's quite amazing because I happen to also find myself in a college with an international community where you meet all sort of people from all the continents. You share rich experiences, people within different disciplines, and the insights and the contributions, the discussions you have over dinner are very overwhelming. And I think so far, I think I've really enjoyed my stay in Cambridge. It's quite an interesting place to be.
Thank you very much. Okay, and finally, Richmond, will you just give us a little bit of advice for the application process?
Okay, thank you very much. I would want to say to all and sundry, especially people from Ghana who want to apply to the University of Cambridge. I think it is an undisputable fact that Cambridge actually accepts nothing but the best of candidates. So in putting together your application, you should be mindful of actually things like your personal statement. You don't want to actually go about beating about the bush, because we are currently assessing a lot of applications. So you never know who is assessing your application, and he hasn't got ample time to read all those fanciful story you want to tell them. Go straight to the point. Tell them what motivated you, why you want to study in Cambridge, what you are bringing on board, and what you want to do with your degree after Cambridge. I would also want to tell them to put together the application quite early, especially if they want to be considered for scholarship, because scholarship deadlines actually run out very, very early. I think the first week or second week of December, applications and scholarship prospects will be closed. And I just want to demystify this whole myth around applying to Cambridge as being impossible. I think many of us think that studying in Cambridge is true that it's not for just anybody at all. But as long as you have been able to study in a university and you've come out successfully, means that you are a potential candidate to study in Cambridge. So people shouldn't belittle themselves. They should just put the application together and support it with prayer. And I believe strongly that things will really go well as expected.
Thank you very much for a whole flavour of Cambridge. Thank you, Richmond.
Thank you very much.